What's up, guys? I'm back with another D3 Monk video. I know it's been a while. The game has kind of drawn me back in a little bit here over the last couple weeks, so I'm going to show you the changes I've made to my Monk. I'm still a Monk tank, meaning that I'm a more defensively geared Monk. And I've got a couple new items and such, so let's get in here. We're going to go back to the second heart. As usual, this is my favorite farm quest. But I'm just going to start off by showing you my spec and my gear. And I'm actually a fire monk now, as it's called. So what that basically means is that I have a build centered around the Burning Axe of Sankis. Or Sankis, I don't know how you say it. But it's basically centered around this item. And the reason for that is primarily because of that third modifier there. Fire skills deal 21% more damage. So that means that any kind of damage I do that is fire is enhanced by 21%. So you'll see right now that my DPS is 35,000, 35.5, I guess. I was at around like 40. I was a little over, a little under, depending on my gear, 40,000 with my previous normal weapon. It did about 1,000 DPS, and it had like some dex and some crit damage. But at any rate, you can get one of these axes for really cheap. And what I was going to point out is that although my raw damage on the character screen is lower, my effective damage is actually much the same, if not actually higher than what it was before. I feel like it might be a little higher. So, you know, there's about a 5,000 character sheet DPS difference, but I actually feel like I do, again, the same or better. And most importantly is that I'm even more resilient than I already was. So what you want to look for in a Burning Axe of Sankis is, obviously, you know, the highest DPS one you can find, but the most important thing is to find one that has critical hit damage on it, because the weapon has life on hit built into it. This one's a fairly high roll, at 635. I think it can go up to like 800 or so. But I've seen them as low as 400. But they'll have it no matter what, so as long as you have life on hit, which it will, it's fine. So just try and get one with critical hit damage. If you're rich, then you'll want to get one with a socket, because they only go up to, like, I think 65% critical hit damage on their own. Whereas if you have a socket, you know, obviously you could put a, you know, like a perfect star or whatever in there. And that would give you 100% crit damage, or you know, 90 or 80 or whatever you can afford. So a socket is the best, but this one that you're looking at right now is a pretty high damage roll. It's a 21% fire damage, which is pretty high. And this one cost me 6 mil. I had one before this that did 870 DPS, and it had mostly the exact same stats, and that one only cost me 3 mil. I just bought it, so I don't have a lot of gold right now. But, you know, they're not that expensive is my point. You can get one on the cheap for like 2 to 3 mil. So just try and find one with crit hit damage and the highest fire skill damage percent you can find. So with that said, the rest of my gear, I do stack fire resistance, so that makes it even better. Oh, excuse me, and the last modifier there, chance to fight through the pain, that actually casts the barbarian skill ignore pain on you. And you'll see it when I get hit. You'll notice there are red shields that float around me, and that's how you know that's active. And that reduces all damage by 65%, so that's really useful if you want to be a survivable character. So at any rate, the rest of my gear, just for comparison. So these are the boots that I'm wearing right now. They don't have run speed. I actually normally wear these boots. And there you go, just see a comparison there. They're basically the same item, except that one has run speed and the other has life regen. I do prefer having run speed, but just for the purposes of this video to show you guys how good life regen is, I'm going to wear these. And you'll see a theme throughout my gear with some life regen. It's pretty high for me. I'll pull my stats up here in a second. This shield was really expensive. it's probably one of the more expensive things I've bought. I really like it, though. It's got a really high crit chance. Huge dex, over 300 with the socket. Dual res, vite, pretty high block chance. What more can you ask for? The only real thing it lacks is it's a little bit low on armor, and then obviously because it's an eye level 62 and not 63, my minimum block amount is lower, but you know, it's not really that big of a deal. And just to show you how much damage this shield adds, that's almost like 10,000 damage. Like, it's pretty crazy. Pants also have life regen on them, pretty high vitality roll. I wish these had armor, but again, I really prefer having the life regen. I've got a ring here with some life on hit. It's around 300. Fire res, armor, and then that damage modifier helps a lot. This is my damage ring. It's got 60 all res, which is nice. But most importantly, it has crit damage, dex, and the straight-up damage mod at the top there. These bracers you guys have probably seen before. I've been wearing them for a while. I've got a max crit chance as far as I know. Really high armor roll. Only fire res, so no dual res, but it's got a pretty decent amount of dex and bite on it, so it's a really, really nice piece. This is my chest. I've had this guy for a little while now, but I've normally had green gems in it, emeralds. I swapped them out for amethyst because my health without them was only about like 31,000, and that is sufficient, but I like to be survivable, and since I've swapped a couple pieces of gear out, my straight-up vitality in my gear has gone down a little bit. So I needed to swap those out. You could do, you know, with less health. You know, you don't. It's not like you need to have over 35,000, but I prefer to have a little bit of health. Got a new belt, and this is one of the reasons I needed to swap those gems from emeralds to amethyst, because obviously I don't have any vitality on this belt, but it's got huge life regen, huge armor, big double res. It's almost a max roll on both fire and all res, and then a little bit of dex, because why not? So this is a really great defensive piece. So even though it doesn't have Vite, it makes me mitigate a lot more. And Vitality is actually probably one of the least important stats in this game. I mean, if you have more than 40,000 Vite and you're not a Barbarian, you're probably wasting mitigation somewhere else, you know, that you should have instead of more Vitality. There's my gloves. Got a little bit of Fire Res on them. Attack speed, 9%. That's very important. You want to get gloves with 9% attack speed, because this axe is only a 1.3 speed, so that is one of the downsides to it. But that's not bad. It's not terribly slow. So get attack speed gloves if you can afford it. Get crit hit, hit chance, or crit damage. More life regen there. And again, I have 580 life regen on the chest. 300 and some odd life regen on the shoulders. Big armor roll. Got a little bit of max percent life, which is a nice stat to have. Decent fire res roll, a little bit of low vite, and a big chunk of dex, so that's really useful. I've had this helm since the beginning of time. It's like impossible to replace. It has a pretty high roll of both reses. It's got a small amount of dex and vite, but more importantly, it has a socket and a very high crit hit chance, so that's pretty much impossible for me to replace. I tried using a madstone for a little bit, which was nice, but I don't know, losing the socket or the crit chance is just, it's not really worth it. I did swap out my amulet. I had that same amulet for so long, and it was really good, but I have so much crit on the rest of my gear that it became redundant for me to have anymore, so I went for some crit damage. It's actually a pretty low crit damage roll. It's only 45%, but it's good because I have a huge chunk of armor on it, a pretty good size of life on hit, fire res, decent amount of dex, and straight up damage. So, you know, that's pretty hard to argue with because it's such a well-rounded amulet. So then let's go into my stats here before we get going. I'm over 30% crit chance now, which is awesome. 180% crit hit damage. You know, this could go up or down depending, you know, if I find a nice trifecta glove, as they call them, that would be really nice. So I'm looking out for that. 1.45 attacks per second. I was running at 1.53 with my previous weapon, which was a 1.4 speed. So, you know, that's really not that bad. It is going to hurt your spirit generation a little bit, but it's honestly not that much. Dodge chances at 37 with Mantra of Evasion on. Overactivated is 55, and standard activation is 47-ish. This is my armor reduction, and I do use Keen Eye. And when I attack with that, it'll go up to about 11,000 armor. And then the res reduction is 74.03, so 855 all res. Thorns, whatever, you know, it's just kind of there. So my health, there you go. This is my life per second. This is what I wanted to talk about, and I want to show you just how effective this actually is. Watch my health glove down here when I take my chest off and I put it back on. It's pretty damn effective. So that's really good for when you're standing in Plagued, when you're standing in Molten. It's good for Thorns. It's good against just about everything, because when you take a hit, you're automatically going to regen a lot of health no matter what. And on top of that, I'm hitting 1,300, you know, almost 1,400 life per hit. And a lot of that is thanks to this big fat axe of awesomeness. So take into consideration how defensive I already am. This goes up to 78% on my fourth hit of Keen Eye when my armor activates. So I'm sitting at all that mitigation, and I still, on top of all that, get Ignore Pain cast on me when I get attacked. It's incredibly good. So if you think my damage looks a little bit low, considering how completely defensive I am, it's really not that bad. So that's my gear. I'm going to show you the skills real quick and why this build is a fire monk. I use Keen Eye. You obviously have a lot of options here. Again, I prefer to be defensive, and that's why I use Keen Eye. Armor is the best thing because it mitigates all damage. There are certain kinds of damage, like ground effects, that you can't dodge. So you definitely want to have armor. That's why I use it. Although I do prefer, my favorite move is Lightning Flash for Fists of Thunder. Just because of the dodge chance and the fact that Fists of Thunder attacks faster. And that means more spirit regen. It means more hits for Life Leech, which is great. You can obviously use Thunderclap. If you've watched my channel at all, you know I've only really used Thunderclap in one build. This is like the go-to move. Everybody loves Thunderclap. The only reason I don't like it, oddly enough, is probably the reason everyone else likes it, is because of that teleport. I really don't like it because it teleports me on top of targets when I don't want to move. A lot of times I want to stay stationary, and I want to have control of where my character goes, and this can like teleport you right into an arcane sentry. So you have to like wait, and you can't attack. You know, I prefer to be able to move and then attack at a proper range. So that's why I like Lightning Flash better. But either one of these two with either of those runes, you could use Foresight if you want a little bit of extra raw damage, but you'd honestly be better off using one of these two because although your character sheet damage would be lower, you'd attack faster. But I use Keen Eye. The armor is amazing. We'll save this for last year. Hang on. So normally Firestorm is completely worthless, but since we have a modifier on our weapon that does, you know, 21% extra fire damage, that makes this actually do more damage than Bladestorm does. Than Bladestorm does. So that's awesome because you're doing, you know, 6% more damage or whatever on top than Bladestorm, and then you're also getting the larger radius of fire. So that's pretty awesome. And Cyclone is really good, but you normally need Fists of Thunder for the faster attack speed to make that work. So this works perfectly for me because I want to be resilient, and I get huge damage while maintaining resilience. Dashing Strike with Quicksilver, this is like the best move monks have, probably. I know, like, some people are going to flip out when they hear that, but if you're not using Thunderclap, couldn't think of the name. If you're not using that, then Dashing Strike is amazing. It's really amazing, period, because you can charge out of Jailer, you can charge around walls, you can charge through things like Arcane Orb without taking damage, and then you basically, with Quicksilver, it only costs 10 Spirit, and it hits pretty hard too, 160% weapon damage, like that's nothing to scoff at, and at 10 Energy, or 10 Spirit, you can basically use it as much as you want without really having to worry too much about looking at your spirit. And that's why this rune is better than all the rest of them, because the move itself is good, and you want to be able to do it as much as possible. So that's why Quicksilver is amazing. I would say this is one of the biggest reasons I am as survivable as I am, besides, obviously, my raw stats. This is way more useful than even, like, Mantra of Evasion in terms of survivability a lot of times, because you can position yourself, you can catch people when they run away, like, it's extremely good. And it roots, so, like, if there's a goblin, you can just perpetually root them, literally. So that's really useful. Now, this is where you're going to have some decisions to make. You can obviously go with Mantra of Conviction with Overawe if you want to be more damage-oriented. And that'll really increase your damage by quite a bit. But Mantra of Evasion with Backlash actually does a pretty good amount of damage. And when you're getting attacked by Gulgors or Phase Beasts or any of the melee monsters that do a lot of damage, the extra dodge chance is really invaluable, and it also means that, at least against those packs, you're actually going to do more damage because you're going to be dodging so much than probably Mantra of Conviction would offer. But against packs where you don't dodge, Mantra of Conviction is going to be like a huge, huge damage increase. Like against bosses, Mantra of Conviction is way better against bosses because bosses don't attack fast, you're not going to dodge them. So, you know, it's kind of whatever you want to decide. I think my damage is fine, and I prefer to be able to just stand in the middle and laugh at monsters while they can't kill me. So that's why I go with this. And hey, look at that. Backlash is fire. So that means it gets an extra 21% damage from our Burning Axe of Sankis. So that's freaking awesome. Serenity, Peaceful Repose. You can't play without this. If you are, I don't know what you're doing. Your only alternatives are Tranquility or Ascension. I think the heal is the best thing. Tranquility is only a second. It helps your teammates out, but honestly, they probably have their own invincible moves, so you don't need to worry about them. And one extra second, I'd rather have the heal. One with Everything, of course, is a staple. Seize the Initiative, of course, is a staple. And for me, Transcendence has always been a staple. But because I attack a little bit slower, I have a little bit less spirit to burn, so I'm spamming my overactivation of my mantra a little bit less. And more importantly, I have a lot more health regen and life on hit than I ever have. So given that, I find Transcendence, finally, for the first time in my life playing this game, not that I don't want Transcendence, I'd still like to have it, but Resolve ends up being better, you know, because I have enough regen already that I don't need this extra heal. And that brings us to... Bear with me, we're almost done. The secondary skill slot, which currently you'll see I have set to Lashing Tail Kick, Vulture Claw Kick. So there are two choices in this move for fire, and then there's also the choice of Exploding Palm or Cyclone Strike. So Vulture Claw Kick is a full AoE. It does a little bit less damage than Spinning Flame Kick. Spinning Flame Kick is a directional attack. It is not full AoE, so it does a little bit more. I'm just going to say right off the bat that Spinning Flame Kick is actually pretty ass, though. It would be nice if it was more useful than it is, but what really stops it from being useful, A, is that the attack speed seems to be slower. I don't know if that's just because it has to, like, shoot the little tornado out or what, but it seems to be slower in terms of the animation, and more importantly is the range. Look how short that is. It's really not very far. So, like, you'd think, like, if you're deadly reaching and shooting people, like, that might be good. But generally speaking, the monsters will just, like, if they're a runaway monster, they'll just run the opposite direction. You won't be able to hit them. So I would go with Vulture Claw Kick if you're going to use Lashing Tail Kick. I find the knockback that Lashing Tail Kick does really useful against, like, phase beasts, because you can kick them back and reset and have them, they have to run back in, so you can get a little breathing room and let your health regen. But against just about everything else, I find the knockback to be an annoyance. Because it knocks them away and you have to run and chase them down and hit them again, which is not what you really want to be doing with this build. You want to be brawling. But the exception is when you pin them against a wall, you can kind of like knock back stun them against the wall. And that's actually really useful. So that is good. The damage isn't as good as I'd like it to be. It only hits for like maybe twice as hard as your auto attack, it feels like, which is, you know, not that good. So... But it's a decent enough move. It only costs 30 spirit, and you can get some burst damage in against like goblins and such if you've got a full meter of spirit. The best move is actually Exploding Palm Essence Burn. It does all that 745% weapon damage as fire, and again, all of these moves I'm talking about are going to get extra damage from your Burning Axe of Sankis because of the fire damage modifier. So that does a lot of damage over time, and then if you kill an enemy, the explosion will proc like Life Leech and stuff. And that explosion will chain endlessly as long as you're killing monsters within 3 seconds. Well, that was weird. My game crashed again. Let's just go right back into it here. I'm going to have to reset my quest, though. Just a second. I got in, and I killed a monster, and then my game crashed, so I apologize. That shouldn't happen again, and back in we go. So anyway, we're through the intro. I did want to show you guys real quick before we got started the other option, which is Cyclone Strike with Sunburst. You guys know that I like Cyclone Strike. You know that I like Eye of the Storm. It's a really great utility move. But Sunburst, it's fire damage. You know, so that's good, I guess, for this build. But it's the same amount of damage for 20 spirit more than Eye of the Storm. And then that fear is actually just a nuisance because you pull people in with this move, so you want them to be in and you want to force them to be near you, but then you're fearing them away. It's dumb. So this isn't really an option, but just in case you were wondering, yeah, don't use it. And then you could also obviously use Fire Ally if you want to have a minion, but you know this move's kind of shitty too, so don't use it. So anyway, your two real choices are Exploding Palm with Essence Burn and Lashing Tail Kick with the two runes that we saw in there. So we'll start with this one, and we'll kill a pack, and then we'll try the other two, so I'll show you guys all of your options. So in we go. And as you can see, like I said, my damage really is not too bad. I'll put Sweeping Wind up here and show you can kill all these guys pretty quickly. Let's see there. So there's just the straight up Sweeping Wind damage is pretty strong. Again, it is a little bit stronger than Bladestorm, even, so that's good. And with this next big pack, I'll put an Exploding Palm on them, and you can see what the Essence Burn effect looks like. Yeah, we don't care about this guy. We're not gonna do his dumb quest. Oh, and on my fourth hit, there's my armor at 11,000 because of Keen Eye, which is very nice. Oh, here's our first Elite pack. So put Sweeping Wind up, and hopefully you can see. And this is an extra health pack, so keep that in mind when you're looking at my damage. So considering that my damage only says 35k, I'm going to put Exploding Palm on each one of these guys. And I can basically just stand in this. I don't really care about the Molten. I don't really care about their attacks. It doesn't really matter. And I can even dodge the frozen stuff. So, I mean, that's the advantage to this build, is that you're just so incredibly resilient, and really your damage isn't bad. Like I said, this is an extra health pack. So, it's really not too bad. We'll kill some regular mobs with Exploding Palm here so you can see how that works. And then we'll switch to Lashing Tail Kick. Need to find some. Okay, here we go. So I'm going to put Exploding Palm on this guy. And then he's going to blow up, and then each one of these guys that I blow up will have their own little, like, subsequent explosion. Like that. And then it kind of, like, infects. There you go. You see them all blown up there. It kind of infects all the other monsters when they get hit by it. So it's really good for, like, large packs. Like, I won't use Sweeping Wind here. We'll just use Exploding Palm on this guy. So you can see it just kind of, like, chains. And especially in Act 3, you can see it's still going there. Hit those other guys. But especially in Act 3, where you go to the areas that have, like, I don't know, the little scorpion monsters, you can put it on one of them, and it'll just blow up and, like, kill all of the other ones really quickly. All right, so we'll do a second pack here with Exploding Palm just to show you, and I'll pull it out so you can see things a little bit better. Oh, good. This guy is Molten and Plague, so, and Arcane. Here we go. This is a great example. It has all of the most annoying modifiers. So I did have to Serenity that Arcane because I was in the middle of everything, but there you go. This is going to blow up. Dodged it. Oh, and Desecrator? Jesus. Wow. Okay, this is a really good example. So that did almost kill me because I was in Molten, Desecrator, Arcane, and Plagued at the same time. So I feel like... I feel like just about anyone else would have been so dead right there. So, at any rate, if it's anything else that you're standing in, it's pretty awesome. But if you're standing in all four of the worst ground effects in the game simultaneously and you don't somehow die instantly, you know you've got a pretty strong defensive build. So anyway, that's Exploding Palm. You just kind of stick the dot on them. It's not that interactive against elites. You basically just make sure the dot is on all of them as you're attacking. But there's the straight-up Exploding Palm damage by itself. So that's pretty good, considering that that's going to happen, you know, as you're attacking, as you're Sweeping Wind. So, like, Exploding Palm with Sweeping Wind would look like this. Not enough spirit. Whoops, let me get enough spirit here. Hang on. There we go, I'll put it on this guy. So that's just straight-up dot damage that they're going to take, you know, while you're auto-attacking. So that's pretty good. At any rate, we'll kill these Quills, and then we'll go back to town. I'm going to lose my Nephilim Valor stacks. But, you know, I'm not doing this video for loot. I'm doing it to show you guys the Fire Monk spec. So that's no big deal to me. Meh. And let's go to Lashing Tail Kick. And I've traditionally actually not liked this move at all. We'll start with Spinning Flame Kick. But I've started to like Vulture Claw Kick a little bit with this build because it's kind of nice to have a little bit of burst. It's not as much as I'd like the move to be. Like, it's not as good as, like, say, the Bell. But... it's cheap, and since you don't have a lot of spirit generation, at least if you're like me, it's almost impossible to find gear that has good spirit generation on it that isn't crappy in every other way. So I have zero spirit regen, even though that stat is awesome. It's like, I don't know, it's just really hard to find. Oh, you know what, I'm going to transition here to another area. So, yeah, it's nice to have a move that costs less spirit, basically. Alright, we'll just go in here, attack these guys now. Another fortune shrine. Got those everywhere. So the raw kick damage, there you go, crit for 2,000, or 220,000 rather, excuse me. So we'll put that up with Sweeping Wind and we'll kill this elite pack right here. I don't have enough spirit. Reactivate our aura to make sure it stays up. We got a plagued, frozen, something or another. But with this kick, I can kind of sit back and I can kind of cast them. There's those little tornadoes that fly out there. And they kind of like go through. So that's pretty cool because you can do it from a range, but like I said in the earlier section, it takes a little longer, and then it kicks them so far back that, I don't know, you usually have to charge after them again, and since you're not hitting all the enemies at once, you're only hitting what's directly in front of you, I find that this little tornado one is not as good as the straight-up AoE kick. But, you know, it's there. It does a little bit more damage if you want the higher damage. So, it's an option. As you can see, this plague is, like, almost not affecting me at all. I'm frozen right now, and I'm just, like, barely losing anything. And I can actually still leech up my health even while standing in the plague, so that's pretty cool. And you'll see, if you look at my character model, you might have noticed it already. There are those little shields that are around me. That means that you have Ignore Pain. So you can see it lasts for about 3 seconds. And it comes up pretty often. It doesn't seem to have, you know, too much of like a cooldown requirement or anything like that. So that's pretty cool. Oh, hey, a rune sword. This could be good. Nope. So anyway, that's the spinning flame kick that casts the tornado. It, like I said, it would be good if the tornado went farther or moved faster, but it's slow, so monsters can avoid it kind of easily, so you might as well have an AoE one that hits everyone around you. So that's why I use Vulture Claw Kick. And that's what I'm going to use for the rest of this video up until Asmodan. Just to show you guys how this works, because this is what I've been using. But yeah, I normally use either this or Exploding Palm.
Not enough spirit.
Okay, got my sweeping wind up. Kill these guys real quick. Dashing strike does count as a melee attack, so it will reactivate sweeping wind, as you just saw there. And that's what the vulture claw kick does. It kind of knocks everyone back around you. It's useful to maintain survivability, again, against phase beasts and such. But other than that, it's mostly just a damaging move that would be better if it didn't knock back.
The chains.
Not enough spirit.
Oh god, you gotta kill the damn shaman. That little shield they put on is so annoying. There you go, that was a crit for about 160,000 from the flame kick. That was 180,000. So, I mean, it hits pretty hard, but if you think about it, you know, you can do a 1-2 with deadly reach, and, like, those could both crit for 60k each easy, and that would be, you know, close to the same damage. So it's not like, oh yeah, I'm about to kick this guy and he's gonna take so much damage. Like, it really doesn't, you know, do a whole lot. But, you know, it's nice. It's a nice little dump. If you don't need to spam your mantra for spirit. Or for health, rather. Okay, one down. There's that stupid shield that's so annoying. So here's what I want to show you. Let me get some spirit here. Let me get up to kind of around the max. And since we're in this narrow corridor, this is one of the reasons I do like this move sometimes. I do like the knockback part of it. Is that I can kick them, and when they're against the wall, you can just kind of like keep them against the wall. Nah, I kicked them out that time. But if you get them in a corner, you know, that's actually pretty useful, like right there. And you can just kind of like lock them in the corner with that knockback. So that is actually really useful. But obviously, that's not always going to be, you know, the case. They're not always going to, the monsters aren't always going to be positioned in a way that that's going to work. So a lot of the time, you know, you're going to kick them and you're going to have to do this. You're going to have to chase them down after you kick them, which is like that, which is kind of annoying. So that's why a lot of the time I don't kick unless, you know, I just want to kill them real quick at the end or something like that. Okay, moving right along. Just got a little bit left here till Sadea. A lot of times on white packs like this, I don't really activate Sweeping Wind. I just kind of kill them. If there's not too many, because they die quick anyway, and that way I have lots of spirit. Feel the wrath of Yitar. IMO. Yeah, you can see, like, I crit those guys for, like, 70k just with Deadly Reach, so... 60 to 70, anyway. Which is pretty good damage. Considering, that it's free. Because it's a generator. Alright, we got another elite pack here. Waller Electrified Frozen Nightmare. These guys have less health than most monsters, so, you know, they're gonna look like they die quicker than the other monsters do. Which, they do, obviously, but... still pretty good damage. Like I said, I don't know how to calculate exactly what my damage would be. I'm not sure exactly how that extra fire damage modifier here on the axe works. But it seems to be very effective. Now, of course, this stupid shaman is shielding him. What did I just say a minute ago? Make sure to kill the shaman, children! You don't want that annoying shield. What do? Let him put the annoying shield on. There we go. He's stuck against the wall now, so I can kick him a couple times for free. Yeah, and that does quite a bit of damage when you can set that up, so that's good. Oh, I did want to point out also, for anyone who might not already know, the modifier above the fire skills deal 25 or 21% more damage, the add 6% to fire damage modifier... That's really stupidly written, and Blizzard's come out and said that what that actually should say is add 6% damage as fire. So it doesn't increase existing fire damage. It makes you just deal 6% more damage as fire. I don't know why it's worded that way. Blizzard doesn't seem to know why either, but they haven't fixed it yet, so whatever. Okay, we're just gonna move along. In the interest of time, we don't really care about these white monsters. We're just gonna skedaddle on down to Sedaya here. Okay, and again, at the beginning of the video, I did mention, so if you are more concerned with boss kill time, then you would definitely want to go with Overawe, no question, because dodge really does not help you against bosses. They don't melee attack enough for it to be relevant, at least most bosses. But I prefer to gear for elites because that's what I fight most often. So,
oh yeah,
or to spec for elites. So that's why I like Backlash. I also just like the idea of being like the kind of character that dodges and then attacks. And Backlash hits pretty frequently when you get attacked. So it's one of the reasons Dashing Strike is nice. You can catch up with this stupid, annoying boss that runs away all the time. So frustrating. And you can spam your kick on bosses. It's another reason it's kind of nice. Although, Exploding Palm is still probably more damage overall. But you can spam it on them because they don't get knocked back. Oh, why does she do that? That's the most frustrating mechanic. Okay, well, there she goes up on her little spider line. So I'm just going to use these little spider minions to build spirit. So that I can kick her more when she comes back. Okay, and there she is. Kick.
We understood each other. Not enough spirit.
That was a pretty big kick crit. Okay, kill a Sinheart here to open up the gate to Asmodan, and we'll be on our way. Take a drink while I'm walking. Gotta have a drink.
Chokes the air, and our enemies come for us in droves. But this is where Asmodan's evil thrives and festers. But not for long.
Okay, now hopefully we get a semi-nasty hulking phase beast pack in here. be a good example of the survivability of the spec. Of course, I'm saying that now. If they kill me, I won't be. Most of the time, they're not too bad, though. They typically have to be, like, the thing that makes this area dangerous is if they're paired with the succubus. And the succubus, like this, these guys, if they cast the curse on you that makes you take 30% additional damage, and then you get, like, vortexed into an arcane, that can still hurt pretty bad, but that's pretty unlikely, and obviously, you know, you can save serenity for those moments. Okay, wall or mortar, fast, electrified. Well, this guy's graciously put himself in the corner here. Against his own wall. Her own wall. Okay, one down. Two down, and here's the last one. One thing the kick is really good for, if you guys play in multiplayer at all, if you've got, like, a friend that has a bunch of monsters on them, you know, you can kind of dash in and do the kick, and it'll just kick everyone away, all the monsters away. So that's really useful if you have, like, ranged friends, or if you're in a public game and your demon hunter keeps dying, as they always do. It's like every demon hunter doesn't know what defense is. Which, you know, I get, that's probably why you play that class, but come on, man, like, if you're never alive, you're not doing any damage. Oh, man, I really hope my Enchantress doesn't shoot that goblin. Don't do it. Don't do it. I need to build up some spirit. Okay, cool. Okay, goblin down. And Golgor down. Let's see what we got here. Nothing good. Oh, wait. Is that a good belt? All it is? It's a 63 belt. Wow. Okay. Thanks, Blizzard. Oh, here we go. What do we got? Nightmare, reflex damage, vampiric. Okay. And then Waller. So I want you to notice how little I care about reflex damage with this. That's really the coolest thing. Like, all the damage I'm really taking is from them attacking me. And so, obviously, against these monsters, I could Serenity if I needed to, but I could also kick them all away, which would be useful. Now, obviously, I don't even need to do that because they just can't even hurt me. So that's nice. But it's nice to have an extra option in addition to Serenity where you can go, you know, oh shit, and then kick them away. So that's kind of nice. Most of the time I find the knockback to be more annoying than it is helpful. But against a hard pack, it can be kind of cool. Oh, a secondary one. What do we got here? Vampiric, Mortar, Nightmare, Fire Chains. Okay, this should be a little bit tougher because of Fire Chains. No, I lied. And we got Feared, but we don't really care. Just kick them apart if your health gets low. That'll give you more than enough time to regen. You could do that perpetually, you know what I mean? Like, I could kick them, stand here, and regen. And kick them, and stand here, and regen, you know? And kick them, and just keep doing that. And that's another example of why this build is really strong, because you don't really need to have amazing gear to make it work. You just need to have decent gear. And, you know, you'll kill slower than I do, but you'll be able to complete just about any content. And then we're also going to... Yeah, I'm not going to kill those guys. I'm going to try and stay in on Asmodan for you. It's pretty easy to do most of the time. Now, there sometimes, though, basically what happens is he stacks the pools. And if he stacks the pools on top of themselves, that can be pretty hard. But most of the time, he doesn't do that. And if he does, you can kind of move the other way. And it's usually not a big deal. So that's another area where you can kind of make up for, you know, maybe your damage is a little bit lower than other specs. But you're never going to die. And that's the best. Because who wants to die, right? Okay, just gonna kind of kick him. Keep attacking here. And you can also, if you find that the falling bodies hurt you, you can reactivate Mantra of Evasion. I'm gonna go over here for now just to minimize the time that I'm in that. Okay, now there's pretty much no choice. I'm going to come up here, though, because it's going to minimize the likelihood that he spawns a second pool on top of this section. And basically, as long as there's only one pool, I'm really not going to have any trouble at all. If he spawns another pool on top of this, it could get kind of ugly. But even two pools is usually okay. As you can see here, yeah, like you just don't really care. Whatever, Asmodan. I know you're like a demon lord of hell and all, but I'm just going to stand here. And like worst case scenario is you get hit by one of those balls, and then you can just Serenity if need be. But you know, I didn't even need to use Serenity there. So it's pretty awesome. And especially again, if you public play a lot, all the people in public games die all the time. So you can greatly reduce the time of your public runs just by being the guy in the run that doesn't die. So anyway, that's that. I'm not going to leave you guys hanging and not show you the gear, so I will show you what I got. It's probably going to be ass, because I don't have any... Oh no, I do have. I have 5 stacks now. So maybe it won't be, except it will, because that's how this game works. I could maybe give that to my Templar, but I never use him, so that's pointless. Oh, another level 63 belt. You know, that's not too terrible. We could maybe sell that. I kind of doubt it, but maybe. Anyway, that is the Fire Monk. If you guys have any questions, leave it in the comments and let me know. Just show you again, Burning Axe of Sankis. It plays off of extra fire skill damage, and you can be really, really uber tanky with this, even tankier than usual, because you get free ignore pain and all kinds of other stuff, and it's awesome. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for sticking around and checking things out, and I'll catch you next time. Peace.